माई नेम इज रोहित सिंघल एंड आई एम द फाउंडर एंड सीईओ ऑफ सोर्सबिट्स मोबाइल प्रोडक्ट इंजीनियरिंग कंपनी बेस्ड आउट ऑफ बैंगलोर एंड हेडक्वार्टर्ड इन सैन फ्रांसिस्को. So my theorem is that you know the space is mobile space, especially the app space, is the most exciting. Reason why it is exciting is that a single person can code and make millions. There are many examples out there, and so there is an opportunity for everyone. Obviously, as the ecosystem is growing, the competition also is growing. But that means that the better products will shine more, and the inferior products will not. As per one stat, about 4% of the 4% of the developers who have put up their apps on the App Store have made more than $1 million. So the challenge is only to come in the top 4%. So I am doing a talk today in U Story, how to successfully build a product and monetize it as well. There are certain things which you should which you should consider while developing your product. And if you believe that you have come up with a product that you can, that you are yourself going to use, not just because you are passionate about it, but you genuinely need that product, then it all comes down to marketing. And there are some key things that you need to follow in marketing, because this is slightly different from the traditional market where you do online marketing or general marketing. People can find you on a search engine, whereas on an app store, it is slightly dealing from the search engine, and there is a different marketing involved, which I am going to speak about. On the App Store marketing, you know, whichever App Store that you are looking at, whether it's Apple App Store, Google App Store, what you have to make sure is that you somehow get connected with the App Store manager. And it's not as easy as it sounds, but there are certain ways that you can do, either build a video before the launch of your product and really invest highly in that video, because the people out there, these app store managers, they are actually looking to have quality products on their relevant app store. So they are always looking around on the net who are the new publishers and who are making products, and if you do that pre-marketing, they'll definitely notice you. And once you get noticed, they are going to feature you on the app store, and that feature is very critical. If you are a young startup and you don't have a history, that feature can make or break your app. And other ways to network with them is to attend their events, like Google Input Output event or Apple WWDC. All of these people are usually networking over there, and you need to go and meet, and probably event like U Story, where maybe some of those people already there and you got to meet those people to do that. You know, I am of the opinion that we have all now become a global audience, and making an application specific to a particular geography may be a better bet in the short term. But if you have a longer term vision, make an app or make a product, make a platform which is going to eventually benefit the larger audience at a world scale. So the concept of, you know, outsourcing or engineer working here in India or working here in US actually doesn't exist. Most of the apps that we use in India that is available on iPhone, Android are as much successful in India as they are in US. So I think so geography specific apps are very limited, and there are not huge, especially in the application space, there are not many big examples which have only focused on a geography and made it big. Most of the apps are being popular across the board. But, you know, coming down to, you know, like, again, the only thing why you would be geography specific is that your chances to get noticed if you make a specific app of India are more. So your initial entry to market will be easier. But what you have to be, but you can use it that have a bigger vision so that you can take that product at a world stage. There is a good science behind it, like what kind of app you are developing. Whether that app, you know, are you capturing the analytics, whether in that app the frequency of usage is higher, user retention is higher, or even the frequency is low but the sessions are longer. That is, when a user opens the app, he opens it of 5-10 minutes. So based on these parameters, you can decide whether your app is more suitable for a freemium model, or is it more suitable where you can run ads in that. Or you, both the model doesn't work for you, you should go for a paid model. So, you know, basically we have to focus on these three more important parameters. And once we know that, let us, to give an example, if the frequency of the if the frequency of the app is low, but retention, that is the engagement, is really high, that the user is, whenever he opens up, he plays it for a long time or uses the app for a long time, and the retention, that it is over 3 months, then that app is very suitable for the premium model or ad supported model. Whereas an app like a game or a utility app, which a user only opens once in a month or twice in a month and uses it for a specific purpose, like a medical app, I need to see, okay, I got this diagnosis, what is the probable treatment for that? I'm probably going to use it once in 6 months or 1 year. But I'm not going to delete that app because that's an emergency app. So it's better to charge for that app upfront. If you believe that people are going to pay for you in-app purchases, I don't think so. You are going to monetize it. And usually those apps should not fall in the $1, $2 bracket. They should be charged higher because people who are searching for those apps require those apps and they'll pay for it. The investors are also looking for a different mindset, especially investors like the ones who I was lucky to get funding from, Sequoia and IDG. They really make you think differently, and maybe I've been lucky so far. I haven't seen the pressure coming from them where they are telling me to take a more reserved or more conservative approach. Mostly they tell us to take a different approach, and even if the risk ends that we have to go down, so be it. So we are doing that. So, even in the services, a majority of my company is, SourceBits do a consulting work. So even in that, we keep coming up with really new innovative models. Like just 2 days back, we came up with a new model, 50-50 partnership with startups, which got featured on TechCrunch and Venture Meet. And that's because, my investors are quite supportive. There is a lot of talk going on where people are telling that the market is, the competition is too high, and, you should not think about the monetizations upfront. You should worry about monetization later. But I think so, if you can figure out monetization earlier, everyone will be coming to you, and you won't have to go for raising funding. Thank you.